Hi, I'm Lordy Wetzel, the First LEGO League Junior Affiliate Partner for the state of Oregon and a member of the AQUA Adventure Challenge Advisory Team. I'm here with the new AQUA Adventure Inspire Kit to tell you what's inside your Inspire set when it arrives in mid-August. First we get, you're going to get another package which includes your team meeting guide and your 6 engineering notebooks for your team. And you'll get a big box of Lego with 710 pieces of unique Lego for the AQUA Adventure season. So let's open up the box and see what's inside. So in our box, the first thing we're going to see are these square base plates. There are several base plates, and these are going to replace the large base plates you've used if you've done First LEGO League Junior in the past. So we'll set them out, there's 6. These are intended to be used at various team meetings and for your final model build at the end of the season. You'll also find mini Lego bags. There are 2 different numbers on the bags. There are number 1s for your Inspire set and number 2s. Number 2s will be used throughout the season for kids to build and for the final model. It's very important that you don't build anything when you first receive your kit. Everything has a set time to be built in the team meeting guide. Please look through your team meeting guide for the appropriate meeting to build everything. However, today I have brought some helpers to build this year's Inspire set. First, you will need to download the instructions from the First LEGO League Junior website. Then you need to get your kids to do the build. Build is meant to be an interactive model that your team can use to explore the season. It represents a water pump, and when water is put in, the children can turn it to make the water come back out. They can also connect their WeDo 2.0 system to the model . And when they write a program, they can make it run automatically. While the Inspire model and the motor system are required components of the final model, they do not need to be configured in this way at the expo. Before we end this video, there's a few more questions I'd like to take the opportunity to answer. Mostly regarding the new base plate structure. Your team can arrange their base plates in any connected pattern they would like to build their final expo model. If your team already has an extra large base plate from previous seasons, like this one, they are welcome to use the base plate to place their pieces on to hold them securely for their expo model. Additionally, if your team has mounted your base plate to a secure tray or piece of wood for easy transport, they may still use the base plates by placing them on the large base plate for transport. This will ensure that your Lego model arrives at your expo intact. Oftentimes the Lego plates flex, and with the separate plates they may separate in transport. So if your model isn't designed to be separated, make sure they're securely mounted on your base plate on a firm surface. I hope to see your team at one of our expos this season at OMSI, Evergreen Aviation Museum, or the Hood River County Historical Museum. Good luck, teams, and enjoy AQUA Adventure.